Resolved, America should build a wall on the Mexico border. Our country is considered a melting pot for immigrants. We accept immigrants, but we want them to come here legally rather than illegally. Our first argument is how building the wall will increase America's security. Our second argument is that illegal immigration will decrease, and our third argument is that the wall will reduce terrorist attacks and crime. America has a responsibility to protect its citizens, and building a wall will significantly increase the security of our nation.
So, our first argument is that the border wall will increase security. Duke explains that apprehension and fines were here 2016 were roughly a tenth of what they were in 2005. This means that 90% of illegal immigrants stopped coming in just because of a wall. Because of a wall in Yuma, Arizona, illegal immigrants went down 90% in Yuma. So a wall across the entire border could make the number of illegal immigrants lower in America.
The amount of illegal immigration is increasing, but with the wall, illegal immigration would decrease drastically. USA Today states, tens of thousands of aliens attempted to cross illegally every month. Last October alone, more than 66,000 people were apprehended after entering illegally. The wall we currently have covers only one-third of the Mexico border and is very easy to cross. If you were putting a fence in your backyard and have to cover three sides, you wouldn't just build one side, you'd build the whole thing, and that should apply for the border. The new wall would cover a larger percentage of the border or even all of it. The new border wall will have better advancements and make it difficult or even impossible for immigrants to cross illegally.
Crimes and terrorist attacks are increasing, but with the wall, we could lower the chances of an attack happening. Raymond says it might have stopped the crimes that claim their relatives. Can states that they found construction of a border wall reduces the probability of a transnational terrorist attack by 13%. With the wall, we could reduce crimes and terrorist attacks, and we could overall help lower the illegal immigrations coming in.
The U.S. should not build a wall along the border of Mexico. This subject is something that I'm passionate about because being a dual citizen, I love both America and Mexico. But there are a lot of cons that go with this. A wall along the border, just in between America and Mexico. Just picture it. Let that sink in. Probably just think it's a harmless wall or something, something that's just going to keep people out and keep crimes out. That's not really what's going to happen. There are a lot of cons, like I said, like who will pay for it? How is this wall really going to keep immigrants out? Is this wall really going to keep us safe? That brings us into our first argument. Trump believes that this wall is going to keep us safe from drug cartels and terrorists. But in an article, Five Problems the Wall Won't Solve by Michael Dear, there has been no evidence that terrorists have entered the U.S. through the Mexican border. Ever since 9/11, over 80% of terrorists that have committed these heinous acts have lived in the U.S. That's right, they are American citizens. According to a list made by Alex Narasta, out of 154 foreign-born terrorists, only one was Mexican. One. As for drug cartels, they can outsmart checkpoints. Instead of smuggling whole weapons or whole guns, they smuggle them by parts. And drugs, they can just hide them in like everyday objects and put them normal, and it will look totally normal because you would never think that a drug is in something that looks so normal, like a teddy bear or something. And it's scary to think that we're going to build this wall knowing that these people are going to be smuggling stuff in new way, and that terrorists are, like, that our U.S. citizens are bombing our nation.
Instead of building a wall and deporting immigrants back to their home country and taking them away from their families and lives, the government should just give the undocumented immigrants a due date on when to become legal so they have a chance to fight for their lives. If the immigrants get taken away from their families and daily routines, they wouldn't be working to pay. They wouldn't be working to pay for the families and to take care of themselves and loved ones. Children aren't allowed to have jobs, and even if the spouse had a job, it'd be much harder to provide for any children by themselves, especially in America. And the spouse would be worried and have all their attention on trying to provide for the family and worrying about getting their spouse back. According to Detroit Free Press, George Garcia, who is 39 years old, has been living in the U.S. for 30 years, which is more than three-fourths of his life. In 2005, every year, him and his family pay $1,000 to $25,000, which is more than some four-year college tuitions and some houses. Eventually, after more than a decade, he got deported. How do you feel if every day it was a struggle to provide for your family and to get your stuff?
Do you know how much the U.S. owes in debt? According to the government website, we owe about $20 trillion in debt. Also, the wall will cost $70 million in money. Also, plus $150 million to contain it. It is way too much to calculate. If we can't pay it for it, who will? Some who of you might be thinking New Mexico, but we won't give up. They won't give us money. So who will pay for it? China. Can you give us money? No. Why build an expensive wall when we are already way too much in debt?
Affirmative. I should. Yeah. Such a waste of money. If you want to keep him out, just shoot the bitch.
Shoot
that.
He's cool. He's a hedging way.
I didn't ask him. Who's saying it?
Looks as weird as your face. Is head basketball even hard?
No.
Oh,
so
what?
I thought it was
who asked.
Is it possible?
Maybe.
Get in. Let's go.
We don't have to go. We go back and jump. Yeah, no way. Yes,
I'm not.
Two seconds.
My opponent said, how will we pay for the wall? Fair.org estimates the economic impact of illegal immigrants to be over $115 billion annually. With the wall being built, the amount of illegal immigrants coming in will be reduced, and this cost will go down drastically. The money saved from this can easily be able to build the wall. Also, my opponent also said that the drugs could be hidden easily. According to the Washington Examiner, almost 99.8% of legal drugs come from Mexico. You cannot simply just leave these drugs to come to the border unarmed. American citizenship is a privilege and it should be treated with respect. If you want to be a part of this country, you should really will follow the laws of this country.
My opponents may say that America is known as a drug country, but other countries have more drugs than us. Then they said a percentage of how much the illegal immigrants are down after enforcing is but it doesn't stop terrorists and chaos. Most terrorists are in America. The wall wouldn't stop our own citizens from making chaos. They may say that the wall being built would be easier to pay for, but who would pay for it and how would it be maintained?
Border wall will decrease the amount of illegal immigration, increase security, safety, and reduce terrorist attacks and crime. In conclusion, we are not against illegal immigrants from coming to the United States, but would prefer if they came here legally and followed the procedures.
You heard both of our sides from safety to the immigrants, so I hope you can see it our way. Here's a little extra push to our side. The Berlin Wall was put up for a somewhat similar reason. And look here where it is now. Nowhere because it does not exist anymore. What makes a government think this wall will be any different? Thank you for listening to our side. Even if you disagree with us, I hope you saw it our way and know that this could not be any healthy relationship with Mexico. And this is what this wall is supposed to accomplish. Thank you for your time.